spent my DTMS?
The college.
The college is the collection of interrelated programs and data. Okay, it is like a bulk server. Okay, server which is used, we are going to serve any number of data and program. So we are going to retrieve that data and information by using SQL queries. Okay, that is the main purpose. Database means the store information. Okay, we are going to retrieve. For that purpose only we are going for DTMS. Okay, what is the goal for DTMS? Is that managing data two types. Okay, that is defining the structure. Okay, defining means doing some alteration according to the customer's required, and also manipulation of information. Manipulation is also the same of doing some changes. Okay, doing some changes, that is known as manipulation of information. Okay, what are the types of DTMS? You know now. What are the types of DTMS? Just read up. Okay, distributed database. Okay, distributed databases. Okay, this is used in distributed computing. Okay, from the database maybe from here, from other college and other college. Okay, accessing. Okay, that's a distributed database. That's based on the oriented database will be defined based on MOOCs concepts. Okay, next one. This is used in many companies. Okay, database and database managers will be using a large number of networks. That is, they will be using in mainframes. Okay, as I already discussed in morning sessions, in mainframes, this database is used. Okay, for large group of networks, this is used. Okay, that is for mainframe. When you are going to program inside a software company, they ask whether you are excellent in mainframe. Mainframe is nothing but it is a database. Okay, that is in all the language. Okay, the next one, platform. Flat file is nothing but one file. Okay, one file, one program. That is known as flat file. It doesn't have any database. That is known as flat file. Okay, what are the applications of DTMS? Can you list out? For what purpose we are going for this DTMS? Where it is applied? Day to day, real world application. Where we are using? See, everybody is having your own college ID, right? We are storing your mark, everything in college website. You are accessing that. Okay? That is the real world application, right? Then, in which other places you are going for it?
Hospital.
Okay. Healthcare insurance. Every insurance company is having that. Then?
Bank.
Okay. Bank. Most wanted. Railway reservation. Railways. See, while we are reserving the ticket, you are checking the PNR status, right? PNR status, codes, where it is. Okay, that is also a database only, no? Then, okay, then, Amibus is also a type of application, okay? Database there, it is a collection of all the buses from which route to which route, availability of seats. Then, PTH bag will be going. For that also database is there, right? Sitting in home and you are accessing which seat you have to go, which data is available, like that, okay? That is also a type of database. That is the use of database in real world application. Okay. Next, what is the purpose? So listen. Inconsistency means states only as we said, okay, it cannot be defined. And difficulty in accessing data, okay, in accessing data, what is that? If there are many files, it is difficult to access the data. That is also a disadvantage in file processing system, that is data isolation. In some period, in some point of time, the data will be isolated, okay, it cannot be moved, copied, it will just be in standby mode, okay. And that the last integrity problem is that we cannot link it, okay. We have to create another file and store. We cannot integrate from one file to another file. These are all the advantages when they were facing a file processing system in those days. For that purpose only, they have gone for DBS, that is database storage, okay. What is the characteristics of database storage? As we already discussed in the first point, that is real world application. Day to day life also we are using this. Real world applications, okay. The next one, system management, systematic management of information. Everything we are getting right, if you are writing on exam, it is being updated in the next day, okay. It is not stored like that. Everything, every day by day, it is getting updated, okay. That is known as systematic management. Whereas here for file processing, we can't do that, okay. We have to change the entire file or store another file. Whereas it means only just updation alone. Data by multiple user. If you are in a rental reservation, only one person is seeing that? No, many persons are seeing. Even he is seeing myself and other. Okay, multiple persons can be seeing that particular data. Whereas in file processing system, it will be stored in single system and it can be seen only by single user. Okay, that is also advantage, disadvantage. For that purpose only, we are going for this multi user. Okay, that is easy implementation such as insertion and deletion. This point itself says that we can insert, update or delete the required field. Okay, and logical relations between records and data. See, if we want it, this we will be seeing it in that, okay. If we want some related number of data, so we no need to create another new table, okay. We just do the subscribe, that is the query for that particular table. It will retrieve that particular information and we can update using that. Here, okay, no need of creating that particular table again and again. You can just, it's a complex design, okay. The design for a database software is very complex. If there is a hardware and software cost is also more, and damage part if there is something error occurred in the DBMS, what we have to go for a huge amount of cost, okay. We have to go for replacement only, the conventional cost, and also that should be a very returning person to work with DBMS, okay? Not that just like that you can go and work with DBMS, okay? That's it. And this is the first point, this is data abstraction. Data abstraction means it will just give the only some important points, okay? Only the required information for the customer, okay? That is what? Retrieving only required amount of information and hiding other information which is in the database, okay? It will not just display everything. Okay, if I want to get my status of booking a train, it will just display only my status. It will not display other person's status. Okay, that is known as data abstraction. That is displaying only the required information. Other information will be hidden. Okay, that is known as data abstraction. It is divided into three layers. Okay, data abstraction is divided into three layers. The lowermost layer is physical layer. Okay, the next one is logical, and the uppermost is view. View is the third layer, you can just see. Okay, what happens in the physical layer is that it will store all the physical data and everything will be there in the physical layer. Okay, here in logical layer, it will give the logics how the data is being stored and where to store the data and relationship between one data to another data. Everything will be there in logical data, okay. The view data is just this data abstraction will just display the content what the customer want to review. That is known as view layer, okay. Data abstraction, in that it is divided into physical, logical and view layer. This is how the data is viewed in DBMS, okay. Can you get my point? Okay, now just we have seen the outline of what is DBMS, how the data is being viewed. Okay, now the next thing we are going to see schema and instance. Okay. mistakes.